What is shifting meditation or reality shifting, and how do you do it? Let's talk about it. All right, so can you really transport yourself into a different dimension? No. That's not what reality shifting is doing. It's a really cute name for something that's been extremely popular outside of meditation. It's known as the mind's eye. Basically, in essence, reality shifting is kind of like play, like with action figures, when you're out there having incredibly massive imagination ideas, but through a meditative context. Back to the idea of the mind's eye, it's the idea of visualizing yourself doing something. So golfers will do this to imagine themselves getting a hole in one before they tried taking that putt and minimizing the total number of strokes that takes for them to win a game, right? If you can, try this out with me. You feel the grass beneath your feet. It's spongy as you shift your weight from your left foot to your right. The air is warm, sweat drips down the back of your neck, a breeze whooshes along you. The grass whispers, the chill in your neck from the sweat, the smell of dry grass fills your nostrils as you take a deep breath. You breathe to calm yourself. The leather glove on your hand gripping the hard metal club. You line up a shot. Looking down at the white ball, the sun glints off of it and leaves a streak of orange in your view. Are you there? Do you see that with your eye? Do you hear? Do you feel the environment? Athletes do these exercises to help them perform at their best, to be able to do something in real life that they've practiced in a shifted reality. This is very similar to being sucked into a book. When people are experiencing a feeling of where the world falls away around them as they're reading a story, that feeling is real. That is a shifting reality as well. The difference here is rather than following the text of a book, you are doing it in your own head. I mean, we do this all the time. You watch a scary movie and it pulls you in, and you'll feel real fear, but you know it's not real. The idea is to take what is known as stream of consciousness, which is a way of writing stories and narratives that people use for actual storybooks. It's kind of like those writers are doing a shifting reality meditation to generate a story and then just tell you about it. To quote the movie Inception, which really has dream hopping and that kind of thing, the idea is that a waking mind is able to create, and then it's also able to experience. But a sleeping dreamlike state means that you create and experience all at the same time. It's a big game of pretend, but it's so real to you that you can still sense things, but you're not actually leaving your space. It's kind of like when people find a happy place to help them calm down because they're nervous, so they put themselves in a nice place that makes them feel more relaxed. On an interesting note related to how powerful this kind of thing can be, if you were to do like push-ups in your mind, imagining yourself pushing yourself vertically up, the force in your muscles and that kind of thing, that's been shown to actually increase your heart rate, your blood pressure, your body heat, your respiration. Basically, it acts like you're really exercising. There's even research to show that you can gain strength thinking about exercising. It kind of brings up an interesting question, is if a person is exercising, is it that they're imagining themselves exercise so easily because they're actually doing it? Or could it also be the fact that just the exercise itself is what's doing it? What's the separation there? I personally have tried reality shifting stuff, which I just call it play, to have the experience of taking things like Destiny 2's Titan Bubble Titan stuff and applying that to other books like Arcane Ascension and pretending that the rules of this world have the powers of this game, and then you get to explore and experience and feel those kind of funness, really. Now, if you're listening to this, you're like, well, what about the what? What about the how? How do I do this? It's like, well, remember, you're doing this all the time. Whenever you get sucked into a book, sucked into a movie, sucked into a game, you're experiencing reality shifting meditation. I've included in the cards here a list of other guided reality shifting meditations, but it's something that when a lot of times these people talk about it, they make it sound like you're gonna do something magical. It's not magical. It's not mysticism. You're using your imagination to see something. Go back to the example of the golfer. When you're gonna go and do something like reality meditation shifting, imagine yourself physically doing that thing yourself. Good practice, make some eggs. Remember to get the eggs of the refrigerator. Do they feel cold in your hand? The crack against the side of the pan? Do you have an electric stove? Does it take a while to heat? Is it a gas stove? Did you hear that poof when you turn it on? These little small bits of information is what will help you move into feeling more realistic. Remember touch, remember sound, remember smell. Those will all help really sink in the sensation. If you want to talk more about this, more personal experiences, that kind of thing, just let me know in the comments down below. If you have more like how to do kind of questions, we can share some other videos that I've seen doing guidance stuff on it. And if there's something that you really enjoy that like puts you in a flow state, like a video game or whatever, that's another thing that we'll be doing it to. See you.